is what it's like in a dust storm.
Well, kinda. Dust storms are everywhere in Earth's atmosphere. They start in the deserts, but end up in the world's oceans, mountains, and valleys, thousands of miles away. Dust storms provide the building blocks of life in distant ecosystems, but can make it hard to breathe in some of the planet's largest cities. Yet in spite of those facts, we still know surprisingly little about these phenomena.
Welcome to Wavelengths, where we talk about our planet with experts from Scripps Institution of Oceanography, covering everything from the deep sea to the edge of the atmosphere. I'm Kate Furby, a marine biologist and journalist. I got my PhD here a few years ago, and now I'm back, learning more about what's happening at Scripps.
We're here today with Amato Evan. He is an atmospheric scientist at Scripps Oceanography, and he studies dust. When I think of dust, I think of like my house being dusty. How did you get interested in it?
So I got interested in dust mainly when I was an undergraduate student. I was studying physics, and I started studying the tails of comets, which are made out of dust. I started learning that actually dust in the solar system, like stars, are formed out of giant clouds of dust, and it just got me kind of interested in dust in general.
Cool. Oh, that's awesome. So from stardust to earth dust.
Yeah, pretty much.
That's pretty sweet. So why is dust important here on Earth?
Gosh, dust influences the oceans, it influences the landscapes, it influences the atmosphere, it influences snow in the mountains. The impact of dust is like you can find it almost everywhere on planet Earth. But depending on where you are and how big of a desert you have, right, you can move a lot of soil, thousands and thousands and millions and even trillions of tons of soil. They get lofted into the atmosphere, and if that soil is lofted high enough, we start to call it a dust storm, and it can travel all around planet Earth.
Well, I'm excited to learn more about dust today, and I'd love to check out the instruments.
Yeah, come on, let's go. I'll show you.
Cool. All right, well, like, show us around.
Well, clubhouse. Come over here. So Sophie right now, she's cleaning this instrument. It's called a sun photometer. This thing's super, super critical. What it does is it wakes up every 5 minutes and goes and it stares at the sun. And it knows how much sunlight it should be measuring based on like how much water there is in the atmosphere, where we are. But then when there's a dust storm, that dust actually ends up reflecting a lot of sunlight back out to space. And so then the instrument, the difference between what it thinks it should be measuring and what it is measuring, tells us how much dust there is in the atmosphere. And those bits of information are super critical in terms of understanding how dust storms impact the climate.
Cool. So the dust actually does both cooling and heating?
So that's the thing. We don't know yet if dust storms make planet Earth colder or if they make planet Earth warmer. And that's exactly what we're trying to understand with a lot of the work that we're doing here.
Cool.
It's very critical because as planet Earth warms up, a lot of the arid regions are becoming even more arid. We need to know then, as populations expand, as we use more water, we know there's going to be more dust in the atmosphere. So is that a positive feedback to global warming or a negative feedback to global warming?
So why did you pick this spot for all of these cool science toys?
It's because we're right next to this large inland body of water called the Salton Sea. And right now the Salton Sea is drying up, and it's drying up because of water management practices. As that sea dries up, we expect that the amount of dust in the air around this area is going to be increasing. And so we want to be here to both measure how much dust is now coming off the sea as it's drying up, but we also want to be able to have the ability to predict in 10 years what is the air quality going to be like for the hundreds of thousands of people that live in this region.
I'd love to go check out the Salton Sea itself.
Yeah, sure.
Let's do it.
It's close by.
So has the Salton Sea always been like this, like so salty and dry?
No. This area changes a lot on a lot of different timescales, say thousands of years. Starting in the early 1900s, some folks decided that this was a fantastic place to grow food. So to do that, they needed water. So they started diverting the Colorado River water into irrigate fields. But a combination of some bad planning, bad engineering, and a really heavy snow year in the Rockies, and the river burst through some levees, and it was essentially diverted into this basin for about 5 years before they could turn it off.
Wow.
So that's what created the modern Salton Sea. But then at the same time, the Salton Sea was still always shrinking because there wasn't enough water coming into it to match the water that was evaporating out. And so as the Salton Sea became more salty, and because it's so shallow, periodically strong winds would kick up and they would overturn the water in the Salton Sea, would result in low oxygen water up at the top of the sea, which would then cause a large fish die-off. So now up in the North Shore, there's all kinds of abandoned marinas, for example, and boats.
Okay, now it's sounding kind of like a Mad Max on vacation vibe.
Yeah, some people have described it that way.
And what about the people who still live in this area? Like, I imagine dust storms and stuff aren't great for residents.
People that live in this area are pretty darn concerned, not only about the air quality now, but about how the air quality is going to be changing in the future. You know, this area has one of the highest rates of childhood asthma. A lot of the folks want to know, you know, one, why is the air quality so bad? Two, what is it doing to my lungs right now? And then three, how is that going to be changing in the future?
Wow. I had no idea how important dust was. It feels like a matter of life and death out here. Thank you so much for showing us around and teaching us so much about dust.
Sure, my pleasure.